In Jeremiah 12, we encounter the prophet Jeremiah in a moment of deep frustration and questioning, which, if we're being honest, is a very raw and relatable scene where he wrestles with the apparent prosperity of the wicked and the suffering of the righteous. It's a chapter that immediately pulls us in to this dialogue between Jeremiah and God about the things that we don't understand. Jeremiah begins in verse 1 by asking God, "Why are the wicked so prosperous? Why are the evil so happy?" This question is as old as humanity itself, striking the nerve of why does God allow injustice and suffering to continue in the world? Jeremiah's boldness in bringing his confusion and frustration directly to God is a powerful example for us. It shows that our relationship with God can withstand our doubts and our toughest questions. God's response to Jeremiah is both challenging and comforting. He doesn't rebuke Jeremiah for his questions. Instead, he invites him to see things from a different perspective. Jeremiah 12, verse 5 says, "If racing against mere men makes you tired, how will you race against horses? If you stumble and fall on open ground, what will you do in the thickets near the Jordan?" God is essentially telling Jeremiah that the situation is more complex than it seems, and that the path of faith involves trust even when we don't have all the answers. For us, Jeremiah 12 reminds us that it's okay to bring our questions and frustrations to God. Like Jeremiah, we may not always understand God's ways, but we are invited to trust in His justice and goodness. It encourages us to wrestle with our questions within the context of a relationship with God, knowing that He welcomes our honesty and will guide us through our doubts. This chapter is a call to unwavering faith in the midst of injustice. It challenges us to continue to follow God, to seek His strength in our weakness, and to remember His promises to eventually right all wrongs. In a world filled with injustice, our response should be to cling even more tightly to God, trusting that He sees, He knows, and He will act in His perfect timing.